I would like to give over to Mpho to formally just open the exhibition on behalf of the arch, and we are so grateful, Mpho, that you are here tonight representing the family. And Mpho, with the children, if her children can just stand for us so that we also just acknowledge you formally. You may stand, Yaniso.
I'll do the old protocols of the it works for me. There's an African proverb. It says, women hold up half the sky. The rest of the African proverb is, women also hold up the men who hold up the other half of the sky. But nobody says anything about that. And so, just as a note, that when the foundation was developed, the family was really intentional about naming the foundation as the Desmond and Leia Tutu Legacy Foundation. If you ever hear my father speak, he will always and without fail say, he is who he is because of my mother. The choices that he makes, the challenges that he faces, the ways that he is able to stand up and make his voice heard are because my mother challenges him, chides him, cuddles him, loves him, is his friend, and sometimes maybe it's his enemy, I don't know. Not gonna go there, not gonna ask. And I'm gonna circle around back to that. Okay, so first, sorry, have to apologize. Do not have the script. Did not have the opportunity to develop the kind of script that this event so richly deserves. Richard, I love, love, love your work. I had the privilege of coming to watch you work. And so these images that look like shh are more like no, wait, hold on. I know how much, no, I don't know how much work went into them. I can only imagine from what I saw of how much work went into them, how much work went into them, and how gorgeous it is to see these images that jump out and scream at you and then call you in to take a closer look. Because behind the loud image is a quieter image, is a depth that is beyond speaking. So I'm really grateful for the fact that you have partnered with the foundation over years of conversation and, well, you know. So really deeply grateful that you stuck with me. And just to say, when you look through the images and you look at all the places that my father has been, and you recognize how everybody has a story of Desmond Tutu, everybody. For his 80th birthday, I think it was, the BBC on their website invited people to send in their Desmond Tutu stories. I don't think there was a corner of the world that there wasn't a person with a Desmond Tutu story to tell. With an encounter, or an email, or a note, or a call, or an image, or an inspiration. And wherever there is evil, or ugliness, or any kind of injustice, it looks as though he's part of this cause, and that cause, and the other cause, and that cause. Actually, he's not. There's only one cause that he is attached to. And that is the cause of love. My father worships the God of love. A God in whose eyes each and every one of us is precious beyond compare. Each and every one of us is valued not because of anything that we can do, and we can make miracles, believe me, but it's not because of anything that we do that we are precious. It is because of who we are. Each and every one of us is, in God's eyes, a jewel beyond compare. And as we walk into Women's Day, we are going to be drowned in platitudes. I know women power, women equality, women rock, women. I hope that what we walk into Women's Day with is a clear commitment that what I wish for myself, the dignity that I want for myself, the bodily integrity that I want for myself, the standard of pace that I want for myself, I should want for the person sitting across from me, regardless of race, of gender identity, of sexual orientation, of economic status, of education. I don't care who you are. You deserve to be cherished. And I'm saying this because I'm heart sore and I'm heart sick, and you know, I would love it to be a conversation without context, but in the wake of a Me Too movement, I know that I'm not the only person who can stand here and say Me Too. And if I asked, I'm willing to bet more than me would be standing to talk about sexual violence, to talk about violence against women, to talk about bullying and harassment, to talk about what equal pay, what equal dignity. Can we do something different, please? Can we do, like, maybe tomorrow, can we do something different? Like, not make it, we're doing the platitudes again.
again. Don't say it if you don't mean it. Don't say it if you're not going to implement it. Don't say it if you're not going to enact it. Don't say it.
And that's not just the voice of anger.
Actually, the voice of love. It's the voice of love. Because I've seen love.
So you're going to go downstairs, or you're going to walk around, and you're going to look at these images of this person who has love so wide, but please don't just make him a picture on a wall or a nice statement. It has to be a living legacy. It has to be alive. It has to. Not otherwise, what he did was useless, because it wasn't useless. But he didn't do it so that he could become a pretty picture, or a foundation, or a name on a sign, or a, it wasn't for the prize. Can we, if we're gonna honor him, just take one sentence of his, just one thing, for the next week. I'm giving each of you a challenge for the next week. Do the next right thing. The next week, do the next right thing. Whatever that is. Do the next right thing. And sometimes the next right thing is really hard to win anyway. Because you're so precious. You're so precious. And you deserve to be cherished, and you deserve to cherish the people with whom you come in contact. Please.
Now when the night begins to fall, I listen for your call. I listen.